everybody. Welcome back to our second round coverage of the 2014 Even versus SCI Championship. I'm your announcer, KRX, and with me once again in the comms booth is Wind Charger. Wind Charger, how you doing?
Doing pretty good. It's a beautiful day here in Italy at Mugello Autodromo Internazionale. Here for yet again another race of Even versus SCI, as you said. I have a feeling this one's going to be action-packed. Longest straightaway on the circuit. Keep an eye on that. That one may cause problems here.
And for those who are misinformed, this is our second time returning to Mugello. The last time we were here was during the first live coverage for Forza 3. Now, Fallen 215 is once again the only SCI driver on the field, or in the field. He won last time at Iberian. The main focus was between Bandit, Yamagishi, and Zeta. So I think we're going to see another action-packed EVO matchup, while STI is just going to cruise on to victory.
The STI definitely has a speed advantage on that front straightaway. What I'm going to be watching for is, can any one of those Lancer EVOs keep up with that, with the Subaru? And if they do, can they pull away and have enough gap on the straightaway before the start-finish line on the final lap?
That's definitely going to be a tough call. Evo, handling, hands down. STI, acceleration. Alright, so before we get started with our hot lap segment, I'm bringing you guys once again our return of the recap video. Starting now. The first round of the 2014 EVO STI Championship began at the Iberian Circuit. Fallen 215 was on the pole, and the only driver in an STI out of five entrants. There was a bit of a battle between Fallen 215 and Roll Tide 424 at the beginning of lap 1. As both Fallen 215 and Roll Tide 424 pulled away from the field, there was a battle between Yamagishi-san Zeta 0085 and LMR Bandit for the rest of the race. As Yama and Zeta were trying to struggle with both EVOs, LMR Bandit managed to catch up to them leading up into lap 4. The only incident was Yamagishi-san getting loose and going wide out of turn 1 and almost hitting the tire barrier. With only one lap to go, the main focus of the race was between Yamagishi-san and Zeta 0085. Fallen 215 won the race, with Zeta 0085 barely holding off against Yamagishi-san to get 4th place. This has been your EVO STI Recap.
Coming down the front straightaway at the Mugello Circuit, you're going to be in top gear by the time you hit the braking markers, longest straightaway on the circuit. Subaru going to have the advantage. High acceleration, high speed. Coming down the first corner, San Donato, brake at the 100 meter board, and start shifting down. Turn is off kilter, so you're going to drift to the left. Problems always arise in that first corner on starts and restarts, coming through turn 2, Luco, and turn 3, starting a series of S corners on the short circuit. Second or third gear mostly through there. Use some exit on turn 3 to get the run down this medium length straightaway. And on to turns 4 and 5, again, another set of S's. You're really going to be really slow through there. Evo is going to have the advantage through there. Now turn 6, Casanova. Sort of a high-speed corner, hit the curb on the right, sacrifice a little bit of the exit to set up for turn 7. Use some exit curb at the end of Salvelli, and now on to turns 8 and 9. Double apex, right-hander, bring it out all the way to the left, hit the curb, to hit the second apex curb, and then again, longer straightaway. Careful not to drop a wheel there, as it is very easy to do. Now turns 10, Scarperia, and turn 11, Palagio. Sacrifice some exit on turn 10 to hit the curb on the left of 11. Curb on exit, and then get a really good run down this straightaway right here into turn 12. The second of the, of the 180 degree right-hand corners. On the exit, sacrifice some of it, come all the way to the right, and then the sharp turns 13 and 14. S-curb hits both curbs. Be careful not to take too much curb on the right-hander, as your car will roll. And now on the turn 15, Busine, 180-degree left-hand corner, The car will slide all the way to the right, sacrifice just a little bit of the exit to hit the exit curb, and then start the long run down the front straightaway. And that is a lap at the Mugello Autodromo Internazionale. Starting on the pole, the only Subaru in the field, Fallen 215, alongside him, Yamagishi-san.
In row two, we have two Evos, LMR Bandit and Roll Tide 424.
Burning shotgun on the field is Zeta 0085.
And the second round of the 2014 Evo SCI Series of Mugello begins. Fallen 215 gets the lead, followed by Yamagishi-san, Roll Tide, Zeta, and Bandit.
Both Roll Tide and Zeta got a good jump off the start. Roll Tide got one really good start. He's going to clear Yamagishi-san before San Donato.
All right, they're going to be making their way up towards turn one, and Zeta just gave Yamagishi a little love tap there, swerved him a bit. As Zeta is trying to pass Bandit, and Yamagishi is trying to find an opening on Roll Tide. As we race on board with Roll Tide in second place, we see Yamagishi-san, Bandit, and Zeta right behind him.
A little bit of a cut by Yamagishi-san as Roll Tide runs off the racetrack.
And Yama's blocking Bandit. This is going to allow Zeta to creep on through. And we see Roll Tide slow down a bit. This is going to give Yamagishi-san a chance to catch up. They're almost side-by-side going up the hill. Yama bumps into the left rear of Roll Tide. I think Bandit's liking this, seeing these two battle it out. This will allow him to gain some ground, as Zeta catches right up with that conga line of Evos. And we see Zeta trying to pass. Oh, Roll Tide lost some ground there. It looks like he's trying to get back on board. However, Zeta and Bandit make contact. 3-wide going down the back straightaway.
Looks like it's going to settle itself out here before turn 12 as Bandit dives it in there, runs wide, Roll Tide crosses over.
And on board with Zeta, looks like Bandit's getting pushed upwards, and Zeta backs off. As Bandit goes on two wheels, almost lost it.
That could have been disastrous for Zeta, who is right behind him. The path that Bandit was taking on two wheels is going to put him right in front of Zeta had he rolled completely over.
Yeah, I would hate for Zeta to have to exit the race early. He almost won here the first time they did an EVO STI championship, and unfortunately both STI Kevin Fallen 215 kind of psyched him out going side by side as we watched the replay in slow-mo of Bandit getting on two wheels. Hopefully he's learned his lesson. Alright folks, we are now on the second lap, the grid as they are. Fallen 215 leads, the SCI driver is now pulled away from all four EVO drivers. We have Yamagishi-san in second, Roll Tide in third, Bandit in fourth, and Zeta in fifth. So right now our main focus is on all the EVO drivers.
It was pretty much a give me going into this weekend that STI was going to win this race, given the long straightaway.
And Roll Tide just went over the curve, and this is going to cause some traction. It looks like Zeta lost some ground as well. So Roll Tide's going to get second. Bandit's going to be trying to hold on to third place with Yamagishi-san right on his side.
Side by side, exiting Savelli.
Making their way up the right-hander, going up the hill. Looks like Yamagishi has the execution with the acceleration to go right up.
A little bit of a bobble from Yamagishi-san. Got a little bit loose off that corner.
As we race on board with Yamagishi-san, we see both Roll Tide and Bandit right up in front. And Yamagishi's going to try to draft off a Bandit in that Evo 8. Looks like Yama's not giving Bandit any quarter. He's going to try to pass. Side by side. Oh, and Bandit goes on two wheels again! Almost flips the car. Okay, I guess he didn't learn his lesson the first time.
Third time's a charm. If he goes through there again and hits those rumble strips, he might as well just go ahead and roll it over.
Yeah, so now we can have our highlight of the day. Bandit flips his Evo third time. Alright folks, the white flag is out, Fallen 215 has crossed the start finish line, however the battle between Yamagishi-san and Bandit is on right now. And it looks like Yamagishi is trying to block Bandit, he cuts him off on the right! I don't think he's gonna let him take it.
He's gonna have to right here, Bandit's on his quarter panel going down the San Donato.
And Yamagishi-san gets it. Nope, never mind, Bandit passes on the exact opposite side going up through San Donato. And Zeta's just like, okay guys, you can have it, whatever.
Textbook crossover move by Bandit. Saw Yamagishi-san wasn't going to make the second apex of the corner. Crossed over, took the position away.
This is going to give Bandit third place. As Roll Tide is starting to pull away from this train here of Evo, the drivers. And Yamagishi-san goes off the track. That was a little unexpected. This is going to slow him down, allow Bandit to pull away and Zeta to catch up.
And with the pressure relief from Bandit, question is, can he catch Roll Tide for second place? Or has he lost too much time with two near flips and Yamagishi-san blocking him down the front stretch?
I think that answers your question. Looks like we just saw Bandit charge right up that turn. Looks like Roll Tide is trying to keep his car under control, which isn't working too well. Bandit seems to have the grip and the acceleration to catch up to him. Ooh, Roll Tide slowed down a lot there, and Bandit gives him a love tap in the right rear.
Moment of truth, can Bandit keep it on all four here?
Roll Tide almost went on two wheels for a second, and Bandit successfully keeps the car on the track.
It's going to come down to Boussin for second place. Fallen 215 has already exited the final corner. He's going to take the checkered flag and win at Mugello.
Alright, Fallen 215, you once again have dominated Team Evo. However, the battle between 2nd and 3rd has already been decided. Roll Tide's gonna get 2nd, followed by Bandit in 3rd. And we have Yamagishi-san and Zeta-85 coming up to finish the field. Alright, that concludes the 2nd round of the 2014 Evo STI Series.
I look at the battle for 2nd, and between LMR Bandit and Roll Tide 424. I think really what cost LMR Bandit 2nd spot is going on two wheels twice, and the fact that Yamagishi-san did not want to relinquish third place going down the front straightaway coming to take the white flag.
Yes, I would have to say Yamagishi is a pretty hot-headed guy when it's coming down to the wire.
It's races like that when it's really short and he knows he has to get every inch he can, but he also knows the point of when to give it up. And he saw when Bandit got to his left rear quarter panel coming in the San Donato, he knew, can't block him, don't force him into the grass, just let him have it there. And Bandit got by him in turn one.
We're definitely going to be keeping an eye on these two throughout the rest of the season to see what happens. I would hate for something bad to occur. Alright, so as for the points, things have changed up quite a bit. Alright, so Fallen 215 leads the championship with 64 points. Roll Tide, second place with 60 points. LMR Bandit will be in third with 56. Yamagishi-san and Zeta-85 are both tied with 50 points each. And as we take a look at the calendar for the next race, we're going to be heading to the Bernese Alps, a first time for Evo STI, and I think for our 2014 season, so I'm looking forward to seeing how Evo is going to handle against STI for this year.
The Bernese Alps is one of those tracks that's got that sweet balance of both grip and speed. Depending on which way you run the layout, you can either have a first corner that's banked or a last corner that's banked. And also that downhill stretch, if you run it in one direction, it's one of those tracks that is really fun to run on. I've ran on it personally, absolutely love it. It's going to be interesting to see how these guys do fare next week.
All right, folks, we'll try to get you down to round 3 as soon as we can. Thank you very much for tuning in. This has been KRX and Windcharger. We'll see you guys again soon for round 3 at the Bernese Alps.